What's up, my fellow LTD addicts? Let's talk about FunnelDash. FunnelDash is a suite of software designed to help you start or grow a Facebook advertising agency. The funnel part of FunnelDash is about using Facebook Messenger bots to attract new leads to your agency. The dash part of FunnelDash is about creating dashboards so you can perform audits for prospective clients or weekly reports for clients you've already landed. There's currently a lifetime discount running at AppSumo for FunnelDash, and in this review, I'll walk you through the ins and outs of the software and help you decide whether it's right for your business. Stay tuned. Hey everyone, I'm Dave from That LTD Life, where I review software tools with lifetime offers. To follow along with this FunnelDash review, you can click the link in the description, that is the referral link for this channel, which means if this review is helpful to you and you decide to go on to make a purchase at AppSumo, it kicks us back a little bit of money here at the channel. However, our reviews are never influenced by the use of that referral link. All right, let's jump on into it. Here is FunnelDash, the annual plan at AppSumo. Now, if you follow along closely with AppSumo, like many people on this channel do, you know that FunnelDash was already a lifetime deal and it's been brought back almost instantly as an annual deal so that you'll pay each year in order to continue using the product. Now, one of the problems with this deal is that it's very hard to understand what you're getting or what you need to buy. Let's look at the terms down here. Here's a little pricing table, which they added after the fact, but the actual terms themselves are very hard to understand. I don't remember seeing this many bullet points on any AppSumo deal ever. So let's look a little bit closer. Let me break this down for you. What are you getting per code? What do the pricing tiers mean? So here is that pricing table from the AppSumo deal page overlaid on the actual pricing page for FunnelDash. You can see that they're mapped directly to their pricing tiers, which is really nice. I like when they do that so that if new features are added, you can kind of know what to expect. So for one code, you're going to get access to the basic plan. For two codes, you're going to get access to the pro plan. And for seven codes, you get access to the agency plan. Now there's an additional tier for AppSumo in that if you add 20 codes, that's about $1,000 a year, $980. A year, you get unlimited access, so you can add as many clients as you like. Now, what is included here? How do you understand how many clients you want? Well, let me break it down for you because I think this is the simplest way to understand it. Each code lets you serve five clients concurrently. You can remove clients when you need to. You can add new ones without accessing support or waiting for approval. You get free reign over that, but you can have five clients added at any one time for each code that you add. So here you can see you get five messenger funnels, five ad audit dashboards, 5,000 contacts, five pages, five ad accounts, one weekly coaching call, and the agency quick start course. Now that's for one code. As you stack more, you can just multiply it by five and you'll get that amount. However, when you hit certain tiers, they'll add in some more information products. So at two codes, you're gonna get some more of their courses. It says Limited Agency Growth Academy. And once you get up to seven, you'll get the full Agency Growth Academy, which I think has like eight or nine different courses in it. And we'll talk about those in a moment. The only other benefit is you get their agency partner certification and some improved support. It says you get priority support without really giving much detail on what that means. Okay, so hopefully that clarifies the deals for you a little bit. All right, let's get started. I am logged into my FunnelDash account here. You can see that I have the option to go between my agency and my client list. Now, a little bit of background information here. I actually do run Facebook ads for clients. I don't have any of them linked up here. My agency is called Client Amp, so you might see reference to that throughout the video. That's just what that is. All right, so let's go into the My Agency section. And you're taken to a bit of a welcome screen here, which has about a 10-minute introduction on how to use the software. There's also the ability to navigate between the funnel aspect, the dashboard aspect, and this deal page, which is kind of like a quasi-CRM. We'll take a look at that. And then there's five steps here, five bullets that tell you how to get started with FunnelDash. Now, I think it's nice that this is here. However, it does kind of bother me that there's no way to clear it, right? I'm always given these settings telling me what to do, even though I've already taken most of them. All right, let's jump into it here. Let's see what the first step is, which is creating a funnel. Now, the goal of funnels inside of FunnelDash is to use a Facebook audit as a lead magnet in order to attract new prospects. So everything we're going to do is designed around attracting people who are already running Facebook ads, get them to agree to an audit with you so you can show them how you can improve their ad spend. So the first thing you need to do is to create a trigger. This is essentially the entry point into your sales funnel. They recommend, FunnelDash recommends starting with the Facebook Messenger ads. They suggest a budget of anywhere between $15 to $60 per day, and they suggest that you should be able to land at least one client per month using that budget. So I actually went ahead and did this already. I created a new Facebook Messenger ad, and I used their template, and I've been running traffic to it for about a day now, and I'll show you how that's going. Now, some of the other options for getting people into your funnel are providing a direct link. You can put a messenger button on your website. You can use a keyword trigger. So if you're talking to someone on Messenger through your page and they mention the word like audit, it might take them into that sales sequence and try to get them to schedule an appointment. Or you can use a QR code. So if someone could scan something with their phone, like say like a business card, and that opens up the Messenger bot and tries to get them to schedule an audit. So let me just walk you through the steps that I've already taken, and then I'll show you how everything is performing. So I chose this Facebook Messenger ads option here, the one in the middle, and I click continue, and it takes you to the setup page where you can create the flow. Now they have some sequences here for you as templates to begin with, and I chose this ad analysis audit consultation. The one over here on the left is basically starting from scratch, and then in the middle, it's pretty similar to this. It's basically just designed to be very quick and simple to get your ads up and running and people into your Messenger bot flow. So let's look at what the sequence looks like. I can do that by clicking on this pencil button here, or the option over here under triggers is called sequences, and that'll take me to essentially the same thing. So here we go. This is the sequence that I'm running. I can view the sequence diagram, which is my preferred way to look at these. It's a little bit easier to understand what's going on. So here's how the sequence works. You run an ad and someone clicks on it. It opens up this Facebook Messenger bot. It asks them if they're already running Facebook ads, and if they are, it asks them how the ads are going. Regardless of what they say, the next step is to ask them if they'd like to schedule an audit. And then at that point, it opens up a schedule now button, and you can send them using a custom URL to book with you using your Calendly or whatever scheduling platform you use. Very simple, very clean way to get this going. This was their template. I didn't really modify it at all. If they say no, it basically says like, well, would you like to start running ads? And if it does, it directs them back up to that original flow. And if they say no, it's like, well, okay, I can't really help you. And then it just ends there. Of course, you could modify this. You can add new steps to it. You're not stuck with it. But for the sake of this review, I thought I would see how the templates fared. This next section here is called templates, and this is where we'll find those three templates we just looked at, but they also have a little bit of an upsell here. For an additional $100, you'll unlock 12 of their premium bots, which you could install on your clients' pages. So as an example, let's say you have a real estate agent and you want to set up a bot for them. They've got a template all ready to go here, and with just one click, you could install it right onto their Facebook Messenger. The next section down here is called Messenger ads, where hypothetically I would be able to see the people who engage with my bot. However, it's not populating with any information, so I'm not sure if it's not functioning right or whether those people would have to actually click through the bot in order for them to show up. However, I did click through the bot and I engaged with it to make sure it was working right, and I'm not showing up here, although I am in the context field. So I'm not really sure if this part of the app is functioning correctly. All right, let's go ahead and look at the dashboard functionality inside of FunnelDash. Now you can see in my account, I have no dashboard, so it's asking me to create a dashboard. Let's think through the process here. So someone goes through your Facebook ad, they engage with your Messenger bot, and they request an audit with you. The idea is that you want to create a dashboard for them to see how their ad dollars are being spent, and then you can show them how you might improve the process for them. In order to do that, you're going to need to get access to their ad account. Now FunnelDash makes it very simple to request access. If you go over here where it says audit request, you can simply copy and paste this link into Messenger or an email, and they can click on it and they'll see a page like this. So your client will see this and it makes it very simple for them. It says Dave would like to audit your Facebook ad account. They can grant you temporary audit access, and it looks very professional. They don't have to do anything technical to go ahead and get that started. Once you've got access, then you're going to go back and create a dashboard. To do that, you'll give the dashboard a title. Now, as I'm typing this, I notice that they kind of go between calling these dashboards and audits interchangeably, which is a little bit confusing to me. Some refinements in the UI, I think, are really necessary here. So to me, these are dashboards. I could use them for an audit, but I could also use them for reporting. Then, of course, you need to link up an ad account. I'm just going to choose the client AMP account here. Now, the next section here are templates. You can see there's an audit template, a weekly client report template, or basically starting from scratch, which they call custom. I can choose an icon and a color for the icon. I'll go ahead and choose maybe this purple color and hit create audit, which again should say dashboard. So this is what the audit template dashboard looks like. You can see it's full of metrics here. I can drag things around to resize them if I wanted to make things more prominent. It's very easy to do. All of the metrics are available to be customized. Simply click the little gear icon. You can choose the metric that you want to evaluate. Of course, you can create filters so that it's only working on particular campaigns or ad sets. I really find this dashboard really usable. I think FunnelDash might be trying to do a bit too much in general. I think if they just sold this reporting dashboard, a lot of agencies would find great value in it, having a way to display the results of their ad campaigns in a very intuitive and beautiful approach. Up at the top here, I can toggle between the different dashboards. So if I only got the one set up on my account here, but if I had multiple clients, I could switch between them right here. I can hit this plus button to create a new metric, a new card. That's what they call them inside of FunnelDash. Let's say I wanted to add a new metric up here at the top. I'd simply click this button, choose the type of card that I want. I'll connect it to the appropriate ad account, choose the metric that I want to measure, create the card, and it'll actually show up at the very bottom, which then I'll have to drag to the top. So this is a little bit tedious. Probably the worst part of the dashboard, in my opinion, is creating those new events and not getting them to show up exactly where you want. But you can see it only took me a second to get it up there. This next mode is for refreshing the data. So if it's a little bit out of date, I could hit this and it'll show me if anything has changed. This next button here is for TV mode that allow me to display the dashboard up on a TV, say in the office, to keep track of how things are going. If I want to share this dashboard with the client, I can click this little arrow over here and I can actually set an expiration date. It says this is in beta, so maybe it's not working exactly right. It says styling issues may exist. So let's say I wanted to share this but have it expire after 7 days. I'll click generate link here and then I can see the link to the dashboard. Just simply copy it and paste it into Messenger or an email so that your client can view the progress of their ads. The next option over here is for general settings where I can rename the dashboard. I could change the icon or even apply a filter to only apply the dashboard to a specific campaign or ad set that you're working on. Then finally, we have the time setting. So if I wanted to view the last month, the last 14 days, I can do that right here and it updates the data. All right, let's move on to the deals section here. Now, this is a little bit of a half-baked feature, in my opinion. This is essentially a sales pipeline where you can get an overview of the prospects and where they're at in the sales process. So when you create a new pipeline, which you do up here, it will auto-populate these steps of the sales process. So on one end, we have an unqualified lead, and then moving along, they either become a won client or a lost prospect. And then you can just step them through as they progress through the sales pipeline. Now, there's no customization, right? I can't change what this says. I don't get any sort of notification or actually there's no way to like automatically bring in leads as they go through, say, your Facebook Messenger ads. You have to do this manually. So you'd create a new deal, you'd enter their name, the deal name, the contact name, and all of the pertinent information here, and it would show up as a little card that you can move across the field. That's essentially it, right? I can click on this to customize if I wanted to edit this after the fact. You can't delete any contacts as far as I can tell. Now, having gone through some of the FunnelDash Academy, it seems to me that FunnelDash is positioning this deals page as a way to get you to engage with their support so that you utilize their white label fulfillment. Now, I have not mentioned this so far in the video, but FunnelDash will actually do the fulfillment of Facebook ads for you. Now, they charge a pretty steep fee, in my opinion, of $1,000 per client. But if you're really good at generating new leads and you just want someone else to do the work for you, maybe FunnelDash could be a good partner. I can't speak on that behalf because I'm not about to engage them for a $1,000 a month client to see how well they do. That said, I'll say that this deal dashboard is severely underdeveloped for any serious sales team. Moving over to the last section here, this is the FunnelDash Academy. This is where they promise to help you become a better ad manager or land more high dollar clients. Now let's go over to all courses and we can see what we're gonna get here. So remember, for the basic plan, you're not gonna get a whole lot. You get access to their quick start guide and then you can jump on their weekly Wednesday call. If you get two codes, you'll become a pro and you'll get access to three of these courses, which is a Tuesday call, a high ticket client toolkit, and a Facebook ad manager manual. Of course, you'll get access to the basic courses as well. So now you'll be up to five total. If you become an agency, then you're going to get access to their certification checklist, their white label case study vault, and an additional call on Fridays. So the question that's important is this training any good? And from my limited experience, I went through about half of two separate courses. I'd say that it's pretty high level stuff. Now they're not teaching you anything that's wrong, but you're not gonna become an expert from listening to what they're saying. It's essentially two guys jumping on a Skype call and recording it. The audio quality was atrocious. It's very hard to listen to for an extended period of time. I'd say you're probably better off taking 10 bucks, heading over to Udemy and getting their top rated Facebook ads course. You'll learn everything that you need to probably. So now that you've seen inside of FunnelDash and you're getting a good idea of how it works, you probably already know whether or not it's for you. However, let me give you my thoughts. I think this is the classic problem of jack of all trades, master of none. FunnelDash is really doing a lot here, but it's not excelling at any one aspect to a great degree. The messenger bot is fine. The template they give you is okay. However, you're probably going to be happier with a dedicated messenger bot platform. The dashboards are pretty nice. I actually really like using them. However, it's missing some key elements like exporting to a PDF or finding a way to share a dedicated link that never expires with a client. So I would love to see that dashboard functionality kind of pulled out and made its own standalone product. I think it would be more compelling than the entire FunnelDash platform. The Academy, to me, needs to be completely redone. The content is okay, but it's presented with lots of ums and ahs. It really needs to be edited to be clear and concise. If you're paying for premium training, it needs to be a premium product. So that said, I'm gonna go ahead and give FunnelDash a 6.7. It's okay, it's only held up because of the dashboard platform. Everything else, you're probably better off learning to do using Facebook Business Manager and then maybe adding it with a dedicated reporting tool. If this review is helpful to you and you're gonna go ahead and make any purchase on AppSumo, I do appreciate you using our referral link, which is in the description below. That helps kick a little bit of money back to the channel here so I can invest the time and energy into making these LTD reviews. If you're new here, make sure you hit that subscription button and click the notification bell so you get notified when new reviews are posted. And you made it to the end of the video. If you like the video, make sure you hit like so I know you appreciate the content. Leave me any comments or questions down below and I'll talk to you in the next review.